We're going to multiply these two three-digit numbers together, so 904 multiplied by 815. And we're going to use lattice multiplication, so we'll draw a lattice. So we'll start off by drawing a nice big square, and then I'm going to cut it up so that it's measuring 3 by 3. So I'm having to make this quite big so that you can see it, but you might get by with a smaller one. I find it easier to use squared paper or graph paper, so you don't have to, but if you don't, then it can be harder to make the squares look square. You'll see that in a minute we're going to be putting diagonals down them as well, so it's a lot easier to do if they're nice and square to start with. So there's my lattice, 3 by 3. Now I'm putting diagonals in, so these must go through the corners of the squares. You'll see why later on, so that we can add up the right numbers when we come to work out the final answer. So that's our lattice sorted out. And now we write down one of the numbers across the top. So I'm going to put 904 across there, but it doesn't matter which one goes where, so long as we put it in the right direction, because they're going from left to right. And then the other number down the right hand side, so starting at the top and writing it down like that. And then we're going to do a bit of multiplying. So starting at the top left hand corner, so I want to work out what's going to go in the top left hand box. So I'm looking at the 9 to the 9 above the box and the 8 to the right of the box. So we're multiplying the 9 and 8 together. So that gives me 72. So I've got the 7 and the 2 in the box like that. Then I'm multiplying 0 by, in fact it's 8, but it doesn't really matter, does it? Because when we multiply 0 by anything, we get 0, so we must put zeros in there. Then we're multiplying 4 by 8, and the answer will go here. So we've got 32, so 3 and 2. So we've multiplied the 8 by each of these numbers at the top. Now we're going to multiply 9 by 1, so that's 9. So we start off by writing 0 and then 9, otherwise if I put 9 there above the diagonal, that would be 9 and 0, which would be 90, which we don't want. So that's 0, 9 for 9. 0 multiplied by 1 is 0. 4 times 1 is 4, so 0, 4. So a nice easy line there, multiplying 1 by each of the numbers. And to finish off with, we're going to multiply 5 by the 9, the 0 and the 4. So 5 9s, 45, so 4 and 5. 0 times 5 is 0 and 0, and 4 times 5 is 20, so 2 above the diagonal and 0 below. So that's the multiplying done. Now to work out the answer, we simply add up along the diagonals. So in the first one to look at the bottom right, we've got 0, and we write that number down here. Then the next diagonal we're looking at is the one that's got the 4, the 2 and the 0 in it down here. So that's going to be 4 plus 2 plus 0 is 6. Then the next one has got more zeros in it than anything else. 5, 0, 0, 0 and 2. So that's 5 and 2 is 7. And then up around here we now get 9, 3, 2 zeros and a 4. So that would be 12 plus 4, 16. So we put the 6 here and carry the 1. We could put it in the next diagonal or we could write it out to the side. I'm choosing to write it in there, plenty of space. So now I'm adding together 0, 2, 0 and 1. So that's 3. And then we've only got a 7 to put up there. And now we can read off the answer. We'd start at the top left-hand corner and the answer is 7,000. No, it's not. The answer is 736,760. We just write all these numbers down in order. So we have worked out that our answer is 736,760. And of course we'll check our answer. Now 904 is roughly 900, 815 roughly 800. And that comes to, well, 9 eighths is 72, and then we put 4 zeros on the end. And we know our answer must be bigger than that because we've rounded both the numbers down. 904 is bigger than 900, 815 bigger than 800. And so getting 720,000 as an approximate answer shows us that there's a good chance that this answer that we got is correct.